Hi dear students, let's see this question that came in JEE Advanced Paper 2 2020 Physics. This was a multiple choice correct question based on the concept of fluids and optics. The question was not difficult from the perspective of physics, but yes, slight use of approximation and mathematical manipulation might have taken away or eaten away a lot of time of some students, and they might have gotten stuck, although physics was not very difficult. Let us see what is happening over here. Here we have a container which has a liquid filled up till height h. The refractive index of the liquid has been given 4 by 3. Now we start rotating this liquid at an angular velocity of omega. So it is given that this shape, the top surface of the liquid acquires this type of shape, which has been asked to assume to be spherical. Although we know that in reality, this surface is paraboloid in 3D and the cross section of which is a parabola. So further, it has been given that difference in the height between this top point and the base, or we can say this point, is h. And h is super small as compared to small r. This is a small r and capital H. So basically small h is very, very small in comparison to radius and capital H both. So using this data, we have to find the value of capital R. Now, what is capital R? Capital R is the radius of curvature of this surface, which IIT has asked us to assume to be spherical, approximately spherical. And we have to also find the apparent depth of the bottom. So as I told you, the question is not very difficult from the perspective of physics. Mathematical manipulations is what is required. So let us see how do we do this. First of all, this is the, if I draw the scenario, so this is the top surface, right? So we can say that if this is the center of curvature of this surface, so if I draw this again, so this is capital R, this will be small r, and this will also be capital R. This value IIT has given as h, small h. So we can say that in this triangle, which is Pythagoras triangle, so we can say that this r square will be equals to r minus h square plus small r square. So this becomes r square plus r square, r square equals to r square plus h square minus 2r h plus small r square. This will cancel out, and from here we get r as h square plus r square divided by 2h, right? So we can say that option A matches, h square plus r square by 2h. Option B obviously will be wrong, because if you see, this becomes 2r square plus r square upon 2h, and 2r square cannot be equal to h square because r was given much, much larger than h. So if this is right, B has to be wrong. Let's talk about apparent depth. Before talking about apparent depth, let's do slight manipulation. Now IIT has asked us to assume this as a spherical, but in reality we know that this is a paraboloid and the cross section of this is a parabola, whose equation is nothing but y is equals to omega square x square by 2 gravity, right? So if this is the origin, this equation is written with respect to this origin. So we can say that for this point, y will be this, which is h. This thing will become h, and x will be small r. So if you put the value over here, h will become omega square small r square by 2g, right? Now, so from here, if we see, then capital R is nothing but h by 2 plus r square by 2h. Now, r minus h by 2, can we say that this is approximately equal to r? Because capital R is super large than small h. So if you see, then we can say that a small h by 2 can be neglected in front of this. Or we can say r minus h by 2 is almost equals to capital R. Because if you think that this is 1 crore and this is 1, so 1 crore will acquire its value because of this term. Not 1 is not going to affect a lot. So we can ignore this. So we can say that this r is actually equals to r square by 2h. Now from here, r square by h, if you see, it comes out to be 2g by omega square. So if you put the value over here, r will become, r square by h becomes 2g by omega square. So 2g by omega square into 2, So this becomes g by omega square. So this is the value of capital R that we are going to use for the optics part of the question. Now, in the second part, we have been asked to find the apparent depth. So for an observer who is looking this ray, it will come like this. So we can say that mu 2. So we are going to use the spherical refraction formula. Mu 2 will be air. Let me draw the diagram once more. So ray is going to go like this. Mu 2 will be air, so that is 1 by apparent depth or image. So we can say that is minus V because it will be imaginably formed over here. So I'm and anyway it is asking the depth, so I'm using the term minus V. Mu 2 by V minus mu 1. Mu 1 was 4 by 3 by U. Now this can be thought of as capital H itself. Although because of slight small h, this thing will be slightly less than capital H. But we can again say that since small h is actually very small, so this is we can assume this to be capital H itself. So we can say this is H and with a negative sign because it is in the opposite side of incidence ray. Incident ray was going in the upward direction and this base is on the bottom side. So mu 2 by V minus mu 1 by U is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 by R. Mu 2 is 1 minus mu 1 is 4 by 3 by R. R value we have already found out to be g by omega square and R will be positive. So we will write g by omega square. So let us see what are we going to get over here. Minus 1 by V is equals to minus 4 by 3H. This will become minus 1 by 3 g omega square. So which becomes 1 by V is equals to minus will cancel out. If we take 4 by 3H common just so that we can get the options correctly. So this will become 1 and 3 will go outside. So this will become how much H? H will become this 4 omega square. 4 I have taken common, so this will become 4g, right? If you bring H here, so this will be H will cancel out, 4 will cancel out, omega square by 3g. Yes, that's right. So this becomes V is equals to 3H by 4 and 1 plus omega square H by 4g whole to the power minus 1. And this is exactly what option D is. Hence C is wrong. 3H by 4 into 1 plus omega square H by 4g whole to the power minus 1. Right. So I hope you would have understood. So as I told you, this was a question based on slight amount of approximation, mathematical manipulations. IIT of late has been asking a lot of questions based on approximation. So while you prepare for your JEE, it is advisable to do a lot of questions which have approximations or approximation question based questions. Thank you.